Video is very important regarding the testing tips, though you know that I have categorized the 110 pages book of testing tips into various tips. But there are some important tips that I will be covering in two parts, and this is the first part of that video. So let's see what are the very, very good advices that testers have given, and they're generic, not specific to any particular area like automation or bugs or the things which I have covered already, which you can go through the series. So let's begin. So the first tip is research till you find a perfect solution. So there could be multiple ways of doing a thing. So there was an author who said that, I think it's Jerry, who said that you should find three ways of doing a thing. Like, don't stop at the first, find the other things, and then you can decide that which one works for you, right? And get your basics clear in the for testing, then you will not get diverted when you read that testing has no future or anything like that, right? And show your presence, like when you are in meeting, talk about things so that people know the importance, and you can show your presence by that, right? Don't sit quiet in any kind of meetings, right? It's not that you have to talk only about testing. There are design and other meetings, right? Theory and hands-on both are important. You should know both, right? You should not just be speaking and speaking, and when it comes on hands-on, you can't do it. Ask for help and offer to, right? Don't try to be a superman, right? If you have a lot of work, do ask for help. And if deadlines are missing, it's better to inform in time than to miss those lines, right? Miss those deadlines, sorry. So, and put yourself in the shoes of clients. This is one of the very important things which makes it different, right? Because an automation suit cannot put itself in shoes of client, right? A person can. So you have to think from the user perspective, what he will do, what are his actions, right? So your business acumen will improve with that. You will have more domain knowledge, for example, in telecom or in insurance or whatever industry it is, right? If you know that how actual user is behaving and you are just focusing only on negative scenarios and not doing what the actual user will do, you are missing something, right? And this is very important. And like, you have to learn, you have to unlearn, and again learn something new as well, right? Or relearn the same concept in a different way. There will be something more coming in the upcoming one. Okay, and avoid reinventing the wheel, right? So some things are already done. Like, you have a good code repo for logging or reporting. So those things you can check online instead of again doing it, right? Unless there is some customization that anyway you can do. Okay, and be self-reliant, right? So I see that some people, they directly post some interview questions or assignment. I would say questions is fine, interview assignment, and they want help from people that. So you have to do the basic minimum from your side and just ask that particular portion. So that proves that, okay, you did your part, right? Be data driven as a tester, right? Your decision should be based on data and not on intuition, right? And but there's a human factor involved too, right? So for example, if I just give you the data, okay, Indian team four players are out, right? Instead of, if what if I say that Dhoni is still there, right? So a human factor should be there, which is deciding, right? Just seeing the numbers, a person might not be able to make a decision. This is an important factor, right? And data helps you to tell how you are progressing. So both the ways it's important, just not the only reliance on data, but with some facts attached to it, right? And understand the context. Like, there are various activities that you do as part of, like, test planning, test designing. So all of that, you understand those things, not just the test execution. And at times you should take a step back and understand things, right, from a different view or from a higher view, like how somebody might be using an application, or to understand the context well, right? And not only just ask questions, do accept them also, right? Some people, they ask so many questions, but when you ask them, they don't have answers, right? So don't be just a one way like kind of communication. It's communication is two way, right? So if people are asking, then you entertain those questions, and yes, when more questions, more people are participating, it will facilitate thinking. So taking notes is an important part, right? Even if you are watching this video also, so some things you might find important. So have your own notes as well, though these notes would be given to you, right? I'll share that this mind map also. But or save it, right? Even if you're using someone else's notes, save it somewhere so that you can refer it easily, right? You can store it at various places, various note-taking apps. And you might have seen that you have seen many recordings, many webinars, even they are recorded, but you never go back, right? So better take it at that time, even when you are doing the test execution, take notes, that helps you. And people have suggested that try to take it with hand or computer is also fine, whichever way, but people have said that they found it handwritten are better. Okay, and treat your test as code, right? As with time, you see that the code gets more and more added, some gets improvised. So similar things apply to your test as well, right? So what the tests you are performing via test cases or without test cases, that is a separate topic, right? So test suite should also grow, right? Like some more and more features are getting added, right? So you should add some cases, remove some cases, maybe a user is not using some functionality, right? Then you don't need those cases. There is a new way of doing a thing and all the users are migrated to that. Then why do you even need a test case or a test in your suite, right? You are unnecessarily wasting your time. Okay, this is something big. Let's cover it up to how you can make your testing easy, right? Read books. So there is a very good book, Buddha in Testing. It's a very small one also. I'll share the link in the video comments as well. There are some communities you can join, some books like Tea Time with Testers, and there are blogs also. Join the communities, right? And apply the concepts that you are learning at these conferences in the various videos, YouTube videos you watch. AMAs, Ask Me Anything, where some guests are invited and the audience ask any questions to them, right? Take some courses, be it an Udemy or a YouTube playlist, upgrade your soft skills. So, and do active participation. At least in 10-15 days, you can have you can open those communities and see what people are discussing. And this is a very important point, right? When you initially join, you think that, okay, this person is having 30 years of experience. I'm just having 3-4 years. So it's fine that people might agree or disagree with you, but there would be a chance of learning if you post. If you don't post, then you are just keeping it with yourself, right? So first believe, then understand, accept, right? No one is perfect. This is coming from this point only, right? No one knows everything. So even like it does not mean that the other person is having more number of experience, so he knows better. Maybe your context is different, right? And your knowledge improves with the years. Don't get disappointed. Yeah, people, some people are having too much of knowledge, right? So sometimes you are starting your automation journey or even you are designing some scenarios, you will see people will come with 100 and you are just having 5. Okay, it's fine. You can compare just with yourself. Don't compare with others, right? They have worked hard. That's why they are there. So you will also be there eventually, right? If you work hard. So invest in your learning, right? When you buy stocks and real estate, all of that, you have to know things, right? Then only you can grow your money. So same here, right? And these are some important areas where testers should focus on: risk, assumption, dependency, constraints. So you can bring this earlier in project, right? So when nobody is thinking, people are thinking just to build the product. So you have to share the problems that are there, right? So this is another very good point. Like, you have to test your product, not user story, because a user story might just say that when a user gives the login credential, he should be able to log in, right? So you should not just test that. You will think around like how many kind of users are there, what all access do they have, are they active users or they are expired. So many things you have to think about it, right? That your product knowledge will help there, right? So user story, you are not testing a user story, you are testing your product. So always keep this in mind, right? User story criteria can pass, but your product might not be working the way a user is expecting, right? And while learning any tool or automation framework, check their product documentation. Sometimes it's very, very good. Especially, I would say this for Karate. They have a very good documentation, right? Because some blogs and YouTube, they cover specific things. And just to tell you that these are some advices given by testers who have found it useful, right? So they may be contextual, some of them. Be strong in your fundamentals. This applies to anywhere you are working and all, right? So you can apply various concepts, the testing concept, techniques, strategies, design pattern, right? And you should know programming for doing better automation, right? And you should be able to have good collaboration. That's why where your individual efforts will fall short, there is, you have a team to back up you, right? And testing is not a phase, right? It does not start after a certain stage when the development is ready. You should get involved from the earlier stage, like requirement and all, right? And walk the talk, whatever you are saying, just follow it as well, right? It's not that you are preaching something that we should do this way and that way, we should not use test case, but you are using test case or the other way, right? Whatever way you are saying, just follow, walk the talk. Okay, during knowledge transfer, it has been seen that people say, okay, I know things, and then they face problems later on, right? So take your time to understand the information that is given to you, because people have faced problem in all this. That's why they have given all these advice, right? And the next point is, if you are doing exploratory testing, right? Exploratory and ad hoc are different things, right? So in exploration, you can record your session, right? Record, because you have not scripted the steps, right? I will do this first, I'll do this first, and then I'll do it, right? You can face multiple problems, right? While doing the exploration. So, and you have not have the exact steps. So if you are recording it, it's good. You can even create a mind map and note down all the observations, right? So, because when you are doing an exploration, right, you are doing it say for 25 minutes, so you might find various things, right? So that can help you. And even especially when you are able to find some bugs, then you can repeat them by watching at that video. So this session means kind of video recording that you are doing. Okay, and pay attention to details, right? Because we don't start afresh daily, right? Generally, when you are doing execution, you have 3-4 days of time, say, right? So you do certain things on day one, and then on day two, likewise, you will proceed, right? So I'll end this video as of now here.